So I work at the Center for Computation and Visualization, and I help scientists to do research by helping them to visualize and to process the data here at CCV. For example, we have the high-performance computing system on which they can process the data, and we also have the YURT system where they can visualize the data.
I changed the parameters a little.
A lot of my interest is to use virtual reality really for scientific visualization, because right now virtual reality has a great interest by society, and a lot of people don't really see the potential it can have for science.
What are all the little blinking things back there?
These are the tiny...
The voyage I took was organized by NASA, and it was on board the RV Falkor by the Schmidt Ocean Institute. And the mission of the project was actually to, in some way, take stock of the ocean. Phytoplankton is extremely important because in some way you can think of it that they are the plants of the ocean. So they help a lot with the carbon exchange, production of oxygen, and they're also the beginning of the food chain for the ocean.
13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18 cells visible.
It's not like looking at the objects on a computer screen. It's more like really stepping into this drop of water and seeing the phytoplankton flying around in front of the user. He can walk around them, he can see what they're doing and how they're oriented to each other. A lot of scientists which we had in the YURT, they start to see different things which they probably might not have seen just on the normal monitor. Computation nowadays is more or less in every field of science. And a lot of the data people are looking at are also inherently three-dimensional. Nowadays, because it got so cheap, basically every lab or every scientist can do virtual reality in their own home and can thereby see the data in a different way.